So the last thing I wanted to do was put an exhaust on my bus, but since I'm going to Burning Man and my tailpipes both fell off, my exhaust is going straight down to the ground. So I'm picking up a couple of pieces just to add it back on there for now. It has 2.5-inch nipples that come out of the muffler itself, and I'm not going to be able to get rid of that right now, but I'm just going to add 2 new tailpipes that redirect the direction of it. But this place is really cool. They do all the bending and everything here in-house. Super helpful and pretty affordable. That's pretty cool, showing the mandrel bend, that the distance stays the same, and here it's not. And then of course, that looks like I bent it. Trying to get a sense for the play in the steering here while you're doing that. Everybody else can hear it though. The people behind you can hear it. I hear it there. When you get an echo off something. just Jake, or did you use brakes?
Just Jake's.
Yeah, that was nice.
Brakes, yeah. I wanted to have mine a little bit longer under the underpass.
Yeah.
You really hurt me.
Take a while to get going.
Did he just merge?
Yes. This all cleaned up. We knew there was an oil leak here, but now we can see that it's coming from the T-fitting there. So we'll take it apart and clean it up, seal it up. That should solve that problem. But everything else so far looks dry. The bottom of the air compressor that we replaced, that's good so far. The tachometer had a pretty good leak. We don't see any sign of that leaking. That was just loose. We just tightened it up. Tightened this clamp here, and we tightened this. Underside oil pan stuff.
Tranny line looks good.
dry. Yeah, I think we made some progress.
We've only been driving for about 10 minutes.
Yep. They usually start to show themselves pretty quick once you have it clean. Our coolant level was full, so we made sure the thermostats opened and made sure that was good. Did you close that valve? You close that valve back off?
No. Yeah. Or
did I? I don't even double check it. So we're out on a test drive.
We're going to get his muffler parts.
Yeah, get my muffler parts. Are your jigs on? I didn't hear him go on there when he stopped.
No, I don't know. They don't come on unless we're going
fast enough.
Yeah.
Temperature
168.
So it's a nice cool day out right now. It's not even, I don't even know if it's 70, is it?
Right behind you there is a thermometer on the wall.
77. But it's cloudy and yellow breeze. Side street, but I don't know.
Well, we're gonna go. Is this it? No, it's
not it. It's okay. It was.
There is a side street we're gonna turn on, but I was just wondering if I pull in front of the business, if there was room to get around back.
I think it's the next one coming up.
Yeah, we're past this.
Dead ends.
I'll just park it right here.
That's great.
You want the other one too?
Yes, please.
I'm not quite as fast as the owner. I'm still finding little bitty steps.
No, that's all right. I'd rather have it better. Yeah. That's great. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. just trying to think what we could do to really get it up to temp and speed. And if we went south on 205 down to West Lynn, like where we were yesterday, came out, pull that hill, that's like a 2 or 3% grade. Not, well, I don't know what grade it is. It's not very much of a grade. We could probably get it up to 10 from there at highway speed.
Well, you're up to 10 now. It was, you know, we watched them open and close. And if you pull that hill going into Oregon City, I think that your thermostat will definitely open there.
Yeah. You know. I was thinking like extended highway speed. Yeah, that's a decent one.
I should have turned the camera. There was a bikini girl barista back there.
They're everywhere.
Really? I've never seen that. We just have Starbucks, and they don't dress like that.
Well, the coffee's probably terrible, so they're probably just trying to compete.
Yeah.
The best coffee we have around here is not Starbucks, it's Dutch Bros. That's amazing.
Caught the light. Jeez, it beats.
Yeah, this sucks. It's heavy, heavy traffic. Industrial area, lots of semi-trucks.
See it.
Oh. Yeah. Yep. Because you don't want to be fucking around. Okay, we're gonna pull this hill.
This is a big grade. My bus wouldn't do it without slowing down a lot.
The problem is gonna be is if somebody else is slow in front of us.
Yeah. What's our temperature heading into this?
176.9.
Okay.
Crack the window so we can hear them. Okay, so we're going like 59. We've got some slow bumps in front of us. And I'm gonna go over because we're gonna pass. VI92TA.
To drive it that hard, it's nice to have it there.
Have it if
but,
you need it.
But it's really, it was spooling. It was.
The YouTubers are going to give us some crap about it. I do not typically do that, just so you know.
Scott's got all these boxes labeled what they are. Nice. So we're replacing this radius rod bushing. We didn't like the way it was coming out at the bottom there. So we're getting ready to remove this. And luckily for us, somebody used Never Sees on those. So that came out pretty easy. And now we're getting ready to take the front ones out. You can see how misshapen it is, and it's not round, and the inside was rubbing weird, so it wasn't holding it steady. And even this one, you can see it's like
this is like 90 degrees, and this is tapered out now at the bottom. These are the two pieces. We're putting one-piece ones back in there. Okay, so I got the new one-piece ones in. They look like this. I have videos, other videos of how to put them in. This is the front one where it gets the that, which is in the line right now. The new radius rod, huh? The bushing. Looks good.